Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I was going to do a little 3-month update on baby Hadley here. We'll see how long this lasts with her in my lap because she is just going through a stage lately. Oh, hey cat. This is my cat, Knox. We have two cats that are brothers that we rescued. But anyways, that's side note, back to the point. So I wanted to give you guys a 3-month update on baby Hadley. We had a 2-month checkup at the doctor's about 4 weeks ago. I'm not exactly sure how much she weighs now, but when we were there 4 weeks ago, she weighed 11 pounds, 4 ounces. Probably weighs like maybe 12 pounds. She's definitely putting on the weight and becoming a cute little chunky. You're becoming a cute little chunkster. She is actually 13 weeks tomorrow on Friday. Yeah, Friday she'll be 13 weeks, and I think this past week she's been going through a really stormy stage. Like, I think she's hitting a growth spurt or something because she's just been a little bit more fussy than normal. She's acting like she is hungry a lot, but she's been spitting up so much. And she's always kind of spit up, but lately it's gotten a lot worse, and I don't know if she has reflux or not. I've been debating on whether or not to make a doctor's appointment, but I feel like she's still gaining weight, and it's not like every single time she eats, but it is, like, the past week it has been more often than not. She spits up a lot. I don't know, I think I might give it another week or so, and if she's still spitting up a lot, then I'll probably take her to the doctor's. Sorry guys, I just realized her swing was on and it was making a sound, so I don't know if you guys could hear that, but I had to turn that off because it was really bothering me and I didn't want to ruin the whole entire video. So she is sleeping in her crib now through the night. We transitioned her to her crib from the bassinet probably when we got back from visiting my family at the end of June, so it's been about a month now that she's been in her crib, and she does great with it. She will usually sleep until 6 a.m., but there are a couple times when she will wake up at like 3 a.m. We've been trying to wean her off of the middle of the night feed because I know that she doesn't need the food because she has nights where she sleeps through the night. So I know that she's not starving in the middle of the night, and it's just kind of like a comfort thing for her. And that's another issue that I've come across with her, is that I noticed that she really does like to comfort eat. And I know, like, I read some books that their schedule should be eat, play, and then sleep, but her schedule is more like eat, sleep, wake up, and play. Like, that's what we kind of have her on right now. And I'm trying to fix it, but sometimes it's just the only thing that calms her down. What are you doing? Sometimes feeding her is just the only thing that calms her down. And now that I've transitioned a little bit back to nursing instead of just completely pumping, I have noticed that she uses me as her pacifier. So, I don't know. I'm not worried about breaking the habit right now just because it's what's working for us, and I don't have all day to calm her down. So if feeding is what makes her quiet, oh my gosh, I'm a hot mess right now. If feeding is what makes her quiet, then that's what we're gonna do, honestly. She is still loving bath time. Like, literally, she's obsessed. And a lot of times we'll just put her in the sink. We try not to use soap every single day. I think I've mentioned that before. But instead, we'll just kind of sit her in the sink and just spray some water on her, and she just loves it, and it calms her down. She doesn't really like the afterwards. She doesn't like after bath time when she gets all cold and naked, but she, yeah, she does love baths. We've also noticed that another way to calm her down if she's being fussy is to just take her outside, and I really do think she loves being outdoors, and it's also just a distraction for her, like new scenery. I notice that she gets super bored if she's inside too long, and if you're like not paying attention to her for more than 5 minutes, then yeah, you're gonna end up with a baby that's screaming because she needs attention all the time now. It's crazy. Like, filming this video, I could not set her down next to me or anything. I would have to be holding her like I am now, or she'll just eventually start crying. Also, back to sleeping with naps, she's doing a little better. Like today, when I was getting ready, she slept for an hour in her crib. But it's very rare that she will nap. Usually she'll have to nap with you holding her. If you try to put her down, she'll realize it and she'll wake up and then she'll freak out. So she is just becoming a super needy baby, but it's okay because she's so cute. Spit up. She has spit up all over her little outfit. I did her 3-month pictures today, and so I got these little stickers from my baby shower and they're really cute. So we did her pictures today. But anyways, so we're still doing tummy time with her. I feel like she's getting close to being able to lift herself up with her arms, but she just doesn't like being on her stomach for that long. Like, I think she'll last 5 minutes until she freaks out. She just hates, I can tell she gets very impatient. She's just like her mother in that sense, because she can't go anywhere and can't move herself, so she just gets fed up and she just wants to be flipped back around. But we've been trying to use her little gym play mat more often and trying to get her to like distract herself instead of us having to pay attention to her 24/7, and she's been liking that. So I'll link the gym mat that we have below, but it's just one that has like the little mobiles that hang from it, and they can kick the piano when it makes music. So she's really liking that lately. She will tolerate the swing for about 5 minutes, as long as you're looking at her or as long as she can see you. I also, like when I'm getting ready, I will put her in the swing or her car seat and face her like right next to me so she can watch me get ready, and that seems to delay her freaking out a little longer. So when we were at the doctor's, I was so excited because our doctor was like, oh my gosh, she has really long eyelashes. And I was like, yay! Because I have been wanting her to get her dad's eyelashes so badly. He has the longest, most beautiful eyelashes. And actually, all of his siblings do. And I was just hoping that she would get his beautiful eyelashes, because my eyelashes are like non-existent, I swear. Her eyes are becoming super light blue. They're beautiful. A lot of people comment on her eyes. What else should I tell then? Huh? She's still getting breast milk. I haven't given her any formula. I haven't had a supplement yet, and I've been back at work for a month. So pumping at work has been a success so far, and my supply hasn't dipped at all. So that's really exciting for me. My goal originally was 6 months, but I think I'm gonna try to breastfeed for a year, just because it really does save you a lot of money. And since I am blessed with having the ability to have a good milk supply and give her those nutrients, then I'm just gonna do it as long as I can until she's more on a solids diet. So she loves the car. Usually she will fall asleep like 5 minutes after being in the car. So sometimes if she really is freaking out a lot and I just don't have the patience, I will just stick her in the car and go drive around for a little bit. And that's how I was as a baby. My mom said that the only way to calm me down sometimes was just to put me in the car, and they would drive me around for hours. She's not to that extent. Like, she can get calmed down pretty easily as long as she has food or she's like moving around. So she is smiling a lot. Like, anytime you look at her or get close to her face and you smile, she usually smiles back at you. It's the cutest thing ever. And she's also getting really close to laughing. Like, she makes these little squawking sounds like she's trying to laugh, so she's really close to doing that. She coos and she talks a lot. I feel like she's starting to get ticklish. I felt like a month ago, like if you tried tickling her, she wouldn't even like realize what you were doing and she wasn't fazed by it. But now she's definitely starting to get a little ticklish, so super cute. So I think that's it for her 3-month update. I will probably do another update at 4 months, and that's when we have her next doctor's appointment. So if anyone has any questions, if I left out anything, then just ask and I will be happy to answer anything for you. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I really appreciate that. And we will see you in our next video. Bye. Say bye.